Building on top of the UI5 TypeScript application we built in the previous episode, we will sort, group, and filter our list of products today. We start in our XML view, where we want to sort our products by category instead of product name. More specifically, we want the category name in ascending order and also group it. In the data model, however, products are linked to the category entity type via a navigation property. Think of the category as a child of the product, so we have to explicitly expand the category when calling the products to be able to access the category name. Let's see if that works. Nice. The products are now sorted and grouped by category. However, for some reason the search and change sorting order features do not work. Let's look at their implementation. In the XML view, we can see that the search field triggers the onSearch method on the search event, and the sort button triggers the onSort method. In our controller, we can see that the onSearch method is being passed an event, which is of type UI5 event. It gets the query as a string, sets an empty filter array, and if a query string exists, adds a new filter to the array that filters for the name. But wait, it's called product name in our data model, so let's fix that. It then gets the table and its binding to then execute the filter method. A little further down below, we can see that the onSort method also uses name, but we want to sort it by category, just like in our XML view. While we're at it, let's also make sure the new sorter groups the items. And now, this is one of the major benefits of using TypeScript with UI5. We can simply start adding a new parameter, and our IDE automatically displays the respective part of the documentation. We can see that we can simply add a Boolean as the third parameter to enable or disable grouping, so let's set it to true. The search feature now works, as well as changing the sorting order. Let's continue in the next episode.